All right, here we go. Hey guys, it's your buddy Lo. All right, so I want to share some news with you. For the past 2 months, I've been taking improv classes. And as you know, I already do like voiceovers on top of Lo knows. And the reason why I took improv classes is because I'm always striving to get better at what I'm doing. I'm never satisfied doing whatever I'm doing at the level I'm at now. I'm always striving to get better, do more, learn more, and just be more creative, and just be more relaxed, and just be more everything. And I thought, you know, and I really figured that by taking improv classes, this would be the thing that would help me move and get to the next level. I've taken acting classes before in the past, but improv, it's just a whole different story. You know, there's no script, there's no kind of like rehearsal, there's no kind of guidelines. It's everything just off the top of my head. And I really felt like with this, it'll really improve things, like, you know, within my YouTube channel right here. So I'm more able to effectively communicate with you and just be more on top of things. And also kind of give me a different dynamic when it comes to my voice acting. Now, my improv final was last night, where we actually we did our improv classes for a couple of months, and then the final was actually doing a live show in front of a live audience, including family, friends, and actual paying people coming to see an improv show. So I'm in the back room getting ready to be called on stage along with my fellow cast members. And, you know, I feel everyone around me is just plain nervy. They're like, oh my God, I'm so nervous. They're sweating. Their palms are sweaty. They don't know what to do. They're feeling like a little anxiety coming on. And me, myself, I'm feeling excitement, like just nothing but pure excitement. And when I feel something that might be maybe considered or interpreted as kind of anxiety or nerves, I don't feel that. I changed that into excitement, to anticipation. And I wanted to basically let you guys know as far as how to look at that, okay? The mind, your mind, obviously, it's a very strong, powerful tool that you have. But at the same time, it's also very easily manipulated. To give you an example, a lot of times, if you're someone who's just like super into like scary movies and you're watching like a horror movie, some people will actually feel like during the horror movie, like they're actually right there, like the killer is actually after them. But no, it's not. Like, you know very well it's a movie. You know that someone's not actually going to come after you. It just kind of shows you like your mind is very, very easily tricked when it feels like it's being put through a situation. So here I am, I'm in the back room. I feel like what could be some kind of nervousness or anxiety. And I'm just like, no, I do not feel nervous. What is happening right now is a change within me. I'm feeling good. I am feeling freaking excited. If anything, I'm at this point right now. And afterwards, after this is all done, I will be this new person. And I am super excited to be this new person. So there is no reason why I should be scared, nervous, or feeling some kind of anxiety or anything. If anything, I'm like, let me go. You know, I am ready to do this. I am ready to go. So once all of this this happens and I'm called on stage, I go out, do the live show. I was up there twice. It was freaking fantastic. And in the end, I graduated. I got my certificate for improv 1. I am ready to go to improv 2, and I am super excited to go into improv 2. It's just because I'm even looking forward to more, to see where I can take this ability, how much more I can improve in my YouTube and my voice acting and just in my life as well. And I highly suggest, guys, if you feel like you are struggling in any kind of way with maybe your YouTube or maybe with just your life in general, and you feel clammed up or nervous like within a public scenario, definitely I suggest take improv classes. It will help you kind of loosen that muscle up within your mind that kind of clams you up, and where you just kind of, you don't kind of say anything. You have that feeling like, you know what, the thought or the whatever you want to say comes to you like 10 minutes later. It's like, oh crap, I should have done that. Improv classes will kind of help bring that out of you. And if anything, it makes you a tremendous listener. Like I said before, with normal acting classes before that I've taken in the past, it's normally like a scripted event. You memorize your lines. You know that a scene is supposed to go a certain some way. But with improv, there is nothing set. It is just you, your imagination, and your partner. Let's create something. Let's just go. And with improv, which I wanted to get to, is that with improv, you have to be a really, really, really good listener. So it forces you to actually listen to the person that you're working with, hear what they're saying, accept what they're taking, and then basically give it back. And if you ever felt like you ever were like had a tunnel vision kind of mindset or mentality, or just kind of the way you just kind of operated yourself, this will help you break out of that mold. And I promise you, it will help you go to the next level. Now, I'm not trying to sell improv classes to you or anything. I'm just saying, if you're looking for some kind of way to better you and better whatever you're trying to do, and just trying to get out of your comfort zone. That's another thing, guys. Never stay within your comfort zone. You will never grow if you stay within your comfort zone. You always want to make yourself uncomfortable to a point it helps you, it makes you grow. They always say, if you ever go to an island on sailboats, you better burn the boats. Because if you always have the option to bail out, then you are doomed. If you burn the boats and you find yourself on a desert island, that way you force yourself to become better, to do things that you have never, ever thought you could do before. Keep that in mind. All right, guys, so I just want to share that with you. I am going to move on to improv acting, improv classes number two. And at the same time, let me share with you my improv final. Improv 1, whatever. Super excited to go into Improv 2 starting next year, guys. Until next time, guys, please enjoy the little improv skit that I did last night. It was 1 of 2. Till next time, guys, I will see you in my next video. Take care. Bye.
All right. So, Lo and Patricia are going to go ahead and get us started. From anyone in the audience, can I please have a relationship that two people can have?
Cousins.
Cousins, thank you very much. Your inspiration is Cousins. This is scene number one.
Well, damn, Shirley. You really are looking kind of sexy today. Damn, you are looking more kind of curvy and voluptuous and everything. That's just the kind of thing I like.
And you are looking very handsome.
You say the same thing. I just got that tooth filled. You like that?
It's so very handsome. It's very becoming.
Oh, my God. So, I was just thinking about that. I mean, I see that you're expecting, what were you, like 7 months pregnant?
Yeah, 7 months.
Do you mind that after you have the baby, that maybe we can, like, can we set up like a date or something? Because I've been having my eye on you a very long time. Like, you know, oh God, you know, yeah, Sally or Marsha.
I would love to, but time and date?
Okay, how about February? February 3rd. That's my favorite day of the year. All the time. Everything.
I think I have a doctor's appointment that day.
Oh, no, is it for the baby?
Yeah, it's for the baby.
Oh, God. Okay, well, I mean, okay. I mean, I know we can make this work. What about your sister? also my cousin, but at the same time, my brother's wife. And Paul's, you know what I'm saying.
Congratulations, married.
I don't mean nothing. We can just go get guns, shoot a couple ducks, do something or another. You know, just, oh my God. Did your water just break?
No.
Oh my God, we gotta get to the tractor. We gotta get to the tractor. Hold on a second. Paul's gonna get angry at me. I gotta kinda like do the corner. Hold on a second.